When Nina Rahmani returned to Kabul after almost two decades away, she realized something striking. There was nowhere for both men and women to hang out and have fun. So she sold off some of her family's land and invested $1 million to open the country's first bowling alley. In Afghanistan, many men still treat women as second-class citizens, but Rahmani, who is just 27 years old, is one of a growing number of female entrepreneurs fighting back against the system.
Most of the people around me, they were like, it's a risky thing that you're bringing something new and Western in the country. But still, I was like, why not to bring something in the country which was not before.
At the Strikers bowling alley, the security is tight, with armed guards searching guests for weapons and explosives. Last year, a nearby shopping mall was bombed twice by insurgents. Usually, men and women in Afghanistan do not mix, but here, they bowl side by side.
Because all the time there are recreational areas, fun places, but it's only for men. Like if there's a swimming pool, it's for men. If it's a park, it's for men. This is the first time that I see there's an opportunity where like women can come as well.
Afghanistan has been racked by more than three decades of war, and the trauma, stress, and anxiety of everyday life can be difficult to escape. That makes places where people can come together and unwind even more valuable.
Centers like these centers are important in Afghanistan because if you go around in Kabul or also in other provinces, you can find a place that you can feel relaxed or you can enjoy your time. There is a problem.
Unfortunately, at $35 an hour, this pastime is beyond the means of ordinary Afghans. And Kabul's unreliable electricity also means the 12 lanes often stop working. But Rahmani says the bowling center has nevertheless been a huge success, so much so that she's planning to start a league and hopes to open up other lanes across the country.